Hey guys, and welcome back to another episode of Federico Talks Watches. We're going to round out the week answering your questions. What is the best Omega to start a collection with? Oris versus Omega, and let's talk about a hell of a repair bill. All that and more in today's episode. Now, before we get started, customary wristwatch check. I'm still wearing the Messina Lab Uniracer. Recent addition to my collection, really, really liking it. And also, couple new watches on DelrayWatch.com. Just got an IWC Spitfire chronograph, full box, full papers, in-house movement, and a very rare Cuervo y Sobrinos Robusto chronograph, one of the brands that has one of the best bang per bucks for bold designs and complications, particularly in the pre-owned or gray market. All that and more at DelrayWatch.com. Let's get right into it. All right, guys. Well, these are the questions you asked me. If you see me looking down, I'm not being rude. I'm just reading them off. And let's get right into it. Fuego Diego says, what luxury brands have the highest OEM original equipe manufacturer straps for the price? So which brands have the highest quality OEM straps for the price? Well, actually, the brands don't make their own straps. Most of them are outsourced. So most of Richemont, like Jaeger IWC, they use Camille Forme. Some strap makers use Jean Rousseau. FP Journe uses ABP, which is extremely high quality. So they don't actually make their own straps most of the time. I'd say FP Journe has the highest quality straps. I think ABP makes extremely high-end straps. And I think Omega, for the price, particularly their rubbers, I think Omega rubber straps are fantastic. You know, anything else that comes to mind? Honestly, not particularly. I'm going to stick with Journe and Omega. RJMA11 says, can you do an update of your collection video? Actually, my collection has changed quite a bit, so I think I will do that. Not so sure when, though. Now, Mundo_Olivo. How practical are ceramic case watches? Are they prone to cracking since ceramic is more brittle? Should they be used as sports watches? Well, Mundo, I think they should be used as sports watches. Ceramic is highly scratch-resistant, extremely scratch-resistant, almost scratch-proof, and will look brand new for years to come. Now, yes, ceramic is more brittle. If you drop it on a very hard surface, or give it a whack against something extremely hard, it can crack, and that can cause a hell of a repair bill. I've seen a ceramic cased replacement needed for a Panerai radio mirror, and that was over $3,000. So yeah, they are more brittle and it is a hell of a repair bill. However, they are also extremely hard. While they don't scratch and they can crack, I've seen a cracked ceramic case twice in my entire career. And I've seen, at this point, tens if not hundreds of thousands of watches. So I do think it is a good sports watch material, and I don't think you should worry about it too much. Usually when they crack, it's a freak accident. Scotty RR88 says, hey Federico, given that it wasn't around for very long, wondering your thoughts on the Datejust 2 from an investment perspective. Well, the Datejust 2 is the 41mm Datejust. It's the first revision of the larger Datejust. It's, you know, people didn't really love it. It still has the old movement, the case shape, the proportions rather weren't great. They aren't really going up in price right now. Datejusts in general are not particularly Rolex that act as the best investments. But I do think the rarity of them will make them sought after by some collectors. They were only made for a very short period of time. I don't know exactly how long. I'm not going to tell you that they're a good investment. But, you know, 10, 15 years, I can see them retaining value pretty well just for rarity's sake. Massimiliano Montanari 27 says, hey, Federico, hope all is well with you and your family. Thanks, Massimiliano. What do you think is the best watch to start a collection if one was interested in Omega? Well, are you going to go new or pre-owned? I think the answer is always going to be Seamaster. A lot of people might say Speedmaster, but I think you should start time only. Let's pretend you're going pre-owned, because I think that's a smart thing to do. I don't think you can go wrong with a Bond Seamaster. Bond era Pierce Brosnan wave dial Seamaster. Usually pre-owned in nice condition, about $2,000. Not very high service costs, iconic design, tough as nails, and it's an absolute beauty. I don't think you can go wrong with that pick. Jeff.Lozano says, Fed, in your expert opinion, what is the ultimate Miami watch and the ultimate New York watch? Well, that's easy. New York, either Patek Philippe, Calatrava, or JLC Reverso, very Madman-esque, very Madison Avenue. New York's a more elegant city. When I lived there, I wore a suit and tie every day. Miami is a little bit douchier in a nice way, and significantly more showy. So I'd probably go with like a gold AP Royal Oak Offshore, or maybe a Rolex Patriot, which is one of my dream watches. And lastly, Nick Stefan 97. What types of things can you expect, swag and perks, to get in a boutique that you won't get an authorized retailer? Not a whole lot. Some boutiques offer champagne or coffee. So do a lot of authorized retailers. I mean, if you're buying an expensive enough watch, you might get like a hat or a wallet, a pen, something with the logo of the brand you're buying. Some really nice swag I've seen is Breitling had a leather jacket, but I think you have to spend more than 10 grand. And spending 10 grand at a Breitling boutique, he could have bought 10 leather jackets elsewhere. So not a whole lot. It's more about the relationship at the boutique. You know, I guess I've seen some of those Rolex hats and tchotchkes and Patek stuff go actually pretty expensive on eBay. So it kind of might be worth it, but that's exactly what it is. It's swag. It's not anything particularly special. Anyway, guys, that's it for today. Please give me a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. It really does help. And please don't forget to subscribe so you don't miss any more content. Guys, thank you so much, and I'll catch you in the next one. Take care.